You know, looking here, and it can be confusing. Slip floats, does he have enough of them? Never enough, not when you're a fisherman, seriously. But when I'm picking at different areas to fish with slip floats, the biggest consideration I have is the different sizes of the floats to match the conditions, wave conditions, the depth I'm fishing, the size of the jig head and stuff. So I'm gonna try to break down a few things that'll help you when you're fishing slip float crappie in spring, summer, fall, okay? So basically, you see there's so many different styles, big, bad, small, thin, wild, but the number one theme is having that signal for bites, the indicator, you know? It's just something about seeing that little slip float go down. And the premise of slip float fishing is using these little bobber stops, okay? And the little, their pin, very easy to put on. I'll show you how to do that, okay? But the premise is those being put on the line, up on the line, at different depths, like this one's about 5 feet, and it's right there on this rod, that I can adjust it back and forth until I find the exact depth the fish are sitting on either weed, rock, or wood, or sometimes I can put it down 15 feet if I wanted to, if the fish are suspended. But most times, this is about fishing it between 5, 8 to 10 feet down, let's say, adjusting it back and forth, so that little slip float just slides as you have your little split shot. I add that just to make sure that the little jig gets down a little faster, because when I'm using 1/16 ounce, it takes a little bit of time to get down there, and I don't want to go through the area where I'm catching fish, where this bait is way up here. I want it down, drifting by their faces. So I add that split shot for two things it accomplishes. It helps the float stay more vertical like this, and as well, it helps that bait get down a bit quicker, so the float can settle up and then go in the wind back and forth, so I'm in that zone of where the crappie are, okay? So there's different styles, different sizes and stuff, but popular ones are the thin one like that, Northland Light Bite, more like a pencil style, okay? Just thin there. Another popular style, obviously, as you've seen before, is like, looks like a little Easter egg, okay? You can tell they get beat up because I use them a lot. Different sizes. They have like half inch, 3/4, 7/8. You know, if you check online with Northland, you'll see, but most companies have the same similar things as well. I have other ones, a little bit bigger. So if I use, let's say, a bit heavier jig head with or more wave action and stuff, so I can see the float easier, I'll use a little bit bigger slip float, okay? Smaller one, bigger one. And then I have another option I can use, the ones that look like steelhead floats. So I use enough weight so all that's sticking out of the water is the orange by the white line, the black indicator going. And the key is that when these fish bite, they don't feel anything. The floats are so sensitive the way I set it up that it just goes down slow. You know, it's just like they're grabbing a minnow or a little bait fish and they're going with it. That's the key with the slip floats. Slender design, easy to pull down, the fish don't grab it, feel resistance, and maybe spit it out. So there's different sizes, different shapes, but all in all, slip float for crappie, you can't beat it.